Talking about human stories, next up we have an icebreaker speech by somebody whom I think if there was an Olympics for foosball, I think we have a medal prospect for sure. Yeah, he's a huge Vijay fan and he once said that worst Vijay movie is better than Avengers Infinity War. I think that's shocking. I'd like to call upon Toastmaster Dinesh for his icebreaker speech. Trust your journey, Toastmaster Dinesh. Trust your journey.
Thank you, Toastmaster Chitra, for your wonderful introduction. First of all, is everyone comfortable here in this setting?
Yes. Yes.
But I'm not. I'm a little bit nervous as this is my first ever speech in my life. You know, what is the secret of getting ahead? It is getting started. That's why here I am to break the ice. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. As I stand in front of you all today, I want to walk you through the different phases of my life and share a glimpse of all the experiences I've had over the quarter of the century of my life. Starting with my childhood, I was born in the year 1993 on September 4th in Bangalore. I was named Dinesh by my parents, Mother Indrani and Father Rajendran. 3 years later, my parents were blessed with a baby girl. They named her Divya. As a child, I was very scared about my father, as he was strict at everything. Although I never had much interest in studies, he wanted me to study all the time. Because of which, I used to be in top 3 rankings all the time. To be frank, I was very bad at English in my early days. Because no one used to speak in English. Yes, no one, including my English teacher in the school. All the subjects were taught in Kannada, and the conversation with friends and teachers were in Kannada. I studied in Red Fort School up to 6th standard. Due to some reasons, I moved to Prarthana School to continue my schooling. There, the environment was totally different. All the subjects were taught in English, and everyone had to speak in English compulsorily. It was very challenging for me. I struggled the initial days, but then got adjusted. Things were going pretty well until I was in 8th standard. Suddenly, my father passed away because of a heart attack. We lost our hope of living, and mainly we lost the financial support. Later on, to manage household things, my mother started working as a daily wage worker. To support my mother and for my education, I started doing part-time jobs. I used to work in a factory. In my weekends, I used to clean cars. I still remember my first earning in my life, which was rupees 10 for cleaning a car. Those days, after my father's demise, changed me totally. Although the transformation didn't happen overnight, it took me long enough. I became a more responsible person. I started to value people more in terms of how I treat them, how I talk to them. Mainly, I learned the value of money. Moving on, I was good at sports. I used to take part in all the games. In my 10th standard, I had won kabaddi and volleyball tournaments in our school. You know, I was the captain of the kabaddi team. Whenever I say this, no one believes. Everyone used to laugh at me. Yes, everyone are surprised here, looking at my body. So here I have a proof for it. This is the certificate which I received for kabaddi competition. Mainly, I was the captain of the team. I passed 10th standard with a good percentage. I chose science as my combination in my pre-university college. I used to go to college just to play cricket with friends. We didn't have proper lecturers to teach us in the college. But somehow I managed to study by myself. And I was able to graduate with a good, quite good figure. I had planned to join BCA as I was not in a position to afford engineering. But decided to give a try to get into engineering through government seat. With my fair amount of luck and hard work, I was able to get into engineering college named K School of Engineering and Management. That was the time where I felt like I entered into a colorful part of my life. Yes, that's where I had my first crush. In my second semester of engineering, I started liking a girl in my class. She was very beautiful. We had good conversations together. Somehow my friends got to know about this. As everyone knows, news travel faster. It traveled so fast that it reached her ears too. From that day onwards, she started calling me brother. I was broken into pieces, and that was the end for it. Later on, I started concentrating more on my studies. Due to lack of placement opportunities in our college, I had to search job outside, which was a difficult task for me. In order to concentrate completely on finding a job, I had to quit all other part-time jobs. Relatives and neighbors kept on asking me about my job day in and day out. Whenever I walk into my streets, neighbors used to ask me about this. So I started wearing a headphone and bent down my head and walked towards the street just to avoid my neighbors. One day I removed my headphones and started walking towards the streets with my head held high. That was the day when I got placed in Radisys. I would say Radisys gave me a new life to start with. I'll be thankful to Prashant sir, Kushal sir, and Adarsh sir, and Rakshita ma'am for giving me this opportunity. On 4th of July 2016, I came here to Radisys. I've made lots of friends here, thanks to football team where I met more people. After joining Radisys, I also got a new girlfriend, which is my bike. I love my bike so much that I celebrate her birthday every year. Sometimes when I feel like not going home, I sleep here. Radisys has become a second home to me. Well, 3 years down, it has been an eventful and wonderful journey in Radisys. I really think whatever I am today, it is because of my mother, her prayers and her blessings. She worked very hard to provide us proper education, never once making me and my sister think about my father's absence. Finally, if I have to say something to myself from the past, I would say to that kid that things may seem difficult at present, but don't worry, it'll only get better. And for the audience sitting over here, if I have to say something, trust your journey. Thank you.
Extremely heartfelt, emotional and entertaining speech, Dinesh. Congratulations on completing your first icebreaker speech. And you can imagine Dinesh's popularity that half of the crowd has gone off. Okay, the next one.